Hey, badass business owners, now is the time for you to raise your prices before the end of the year. This must be part of your 2022 game plan, and we're going to talk about that in this video. Listen, you are in the business to make money, and at the end of the day, sales are not the goal. Profits are. And way too many people set sales goals but fail to set profit goals. And that's what you're going to be doing, is you want to make sure you set profit goals, and your pricing is a huge part of that. You must price your products and services correctly to begin with. And towards the end of the year is a great time to do an evaluation of all of your prices, because you need to ask yourself, have you adjusted for the higher costs that you've probably gone through the course of the year? Have you adjusted for higher labor costs? Maybe you're paying more per hour to get that labor if you have employees that work for you. I talk about this one all the time. Are you paying yourself as a laborer? You are part of your labor costs. It's a huge mistake people make, and you need to watch my other videos on this, on how to pay yourself correctly in your business, because this is a huge thing that's killing a lot of you guys on pricing and why you can't seem to make any money in your business. And have you accounted for your expenses properly? People don't even think about their expenses when they're setting their prices, and you absolutely must do that. Remember, the number one calculation you need to know in your business is the following: sales minus cost of goods minus expenses equals your profits. If you memorize nothing else of all of your business numbers, you've got to know this one thing: sales minus cost of goods minus expenses equals profits. This is how you're going to set up your pricing. And why do we want to follow this? Well, look at here. This is a profit and loss statement. Watch how crazy this is. Your sales is your top line, where your income and your numbers are, right? And right here, you're going to see a percentage, right? Your sales is everything you take in. So it's 100%. That's your sales, right? Then minus cost of goods, that's also going to have a percentage to it. That's going to be 47. In this example here, it's 47%. But this cost of goods are the materials and the labor to provide the product or the service. And then we have your expenses. This is everything else in your business to be able to run it. Guess what? It also has a percentage of how much it takes of your business and how much of your money it takes. And then finally, you end up with the profit. Sales minus cost of goods minus expenses equals profits. It's how you're going to price, and it's how your P&L flows, because your profits is what's left over after it all. In this particular example, it's 30%, and that's how it should be working. So somebody should be getting paid up here in the labor for the things they do in the business, but down here is the profits the company makes. The business owner gets to take from that. So you're wearing two different hats. You got to make sure you do that right. But you got to be priced right to begin with. And the main thing I want to get across is so many people seem to be in a race to the bottom. They just price way too low than what they are valued at and what they should be at. And yes, I understand many customers want the cheapest. They always want your cheapest price. They want you to come in the cheapest. They're going to shop around for the cheapest. There's nothing you can do about that, but they aren't your ideal customer. If you keep chasing the cheapest, you're going to keep getting the cheapest. And you got to focus in on who is that ideal customer, someone who's willing to pay for the value that you have. And that's part of the problem. You're probably not conveying the true value of what you have. Yes, other people might be cheaper, but if you haven't dug in to find out that they don't use the best materials or providing the right customer service, there could be a host of reasons why their value is way less than yours, which is why they price the way they do. And we're going to talk about that, because the cheapest isn't profitable. You can't always be the cheapest out there, because you'll never make any money in your business. There's some big box retailers who price really cheaply, but they do this because of the volume that they sell. They're able to make it up on profit dollars because they sell so much of it. That's not you in your small business. So quit being the cheapest. It is not profitable. Now, another thing I hear all the time is that some competitors will drive the price down. You're right. There's going to be people out there that are going to be the cheapest. But guess what? You don't know what their cost and expenses are. You don't know if they're making any money at all. So why are you worried about what they're charging? Let them run a poor business. Let them run a bad business. It's not going to work. Nor do I want you to be the highest, because the people that are higher than you is because they have high costs and expenses. You need to find the sweet spot for your business, and that means your prices are probably better. So you need to show your value over them. Always remember that. People will pay for the value that they get, and your job is to make sure that you convey that value and you find that specific need. People are willing to pay for the needs that they have. If you solve those pain points, they're going to pay you. But I also know people are going to say, well, if I raise my prices, I'm going to lose some customers. No, you're not. Let me show you a statistic, and maybe this will help you realize that by raising your prices, it may not be as bad as you think it is. Okay, let's just say you have 100 customers, and whatever product service that you offer, you have $10 in profit. I'm just going to use this example. Follow me through this real quick. So 100 customers at $10 in profit means at the end of the day, there's $1,000 in profit. Now, let's just say you decide, hey, I'm going to raise my prices by $5. Well, when you raise your prices, the vast majority of it goes to your profitability because you've already been paying your cost of goods and your expenses. You're just trying to offset the fact that you never raised your prices to begin with. So now your profit is going to be closer to $15, and it might even be $14, but let's just say it's $15 for our example. And let's say that 10% of your customers decide to walk. You change your prices, 10% of them walk, especially if you have reoccurring customers. Well, now you're down to 90 customers. Well, let's do the math real quick. 90 customers at $15 in profit still comes out to $13.50. I don't know about you, but I will take $13.50 over $1,000 in profits all day long. So yes, you may lose some customers, but at the end of the day, you're making more money. You need to run the numbers. I promise you, it's not going to be what you think it is. You need to raise your prices. I'm going to keep saying it because you are in the business of making money. And the only way you make money is to have profit. Yes, you can pay yourself like a job owner all the time. And that's where people get confused because they're making $30,000, $40,000, $50,000, but they're making it as a laborer, as somebody who's doing the business. But you make the good money when your business is profitable because now you're getting that owner's draw and you're making even more money. Now, you're probably wondering when and how. Well, we just talked about how you need to go about figuring out how to raise your prices. Let's talk about when to do it. You need to raise it now for any new customers that you have. If you're taking on new business, once you've created your new prices, you can go ahead and start those immediately. New people, you know, unless they were in the hopper, you've already got quotes, bids, whatever, you can honor those prices. But for anybody new coming into the system, you want to go ahead and start those new ones. Now, if you have reoccurring business, reoccurring people, what you want to do is you want to let them know that, you know, with the end of the year, it's a great time to be able to tell people that, hey, unfortunately for the new year, we're going to have to make some adjustments to the pricing due to the increase of costs of materials and labor and everything else. Trust me, in this world today, people know that that's going on because there's a lot of talk out there about how things have been going up in price. It's a great way for you to lead. And you're being nice and you're saying, hey, I'm going to give you 30, 60 days notice, depending upon when you do this exercise. But you can just tell them it's going up on January 1st. If you're watching this video sometime in the middle of the year, same thing. Just give them 30, 60 days notice and you should be fine. But don't think you have to grandfather people in. There might be an elderly person that you don't want to change their pricing. You want to keep that in, or somebody who's disabled or a vet or something like that, and you want to grandfather them. That's fine as well. But for all new people and your general reoccurring business, you want to go ahead and get that ball in motion. Now, if you want a little bit more on how to price your products and services, I do have these two videos here that you can check out. And if you really want to learn more about your profit and loss statement, you can see this one here. Listen, folks, I want you to get paid. And the way you get paid is to make sure you're priced correctly. So please take the time out, do an audit on your pricing. So at the end of the day, I want to help you make some profit. And the best way that you're going to make that profit is to make sure that you are priced correctly. Get out there, do it now. Let your people know that you're going to be raising your prices at the beginning of the year, and look forward to a profitable 2022.